Here now with Grandview defensive coordinator Joe Woodley and the exciting win this past Saturday at St. Ambrose in double overtime, Waldorf for homecoming this Saturday. And Joe, this defense may not be a team that maybe has the best statistics, but the bottom line is getting the W's and when it's playing the best when it has to.
Yeah, you're right, Jeff. And, you know, that's sometimes can be disappointing, you know, when you're giving up more yards than you'd like. But really, at the end of the day, all that matters is those wins and losses. And we've done a pretty good job. You know, teams have moved the ball a little bit, like I said, more than I'd like. But we've done a pretty good job of keeping teams out of the end zone for the most part. And, you know, Saturday against St. Ambrose, very high-powered offense, in my opinion. And I thought our kids played pretty good overall. Really got a lot better as the game went on, I thought. But, yeah, well, you know, statistics, you can take them for what they're worth, but at the end of the day, it's, you know, it's wins and losses, and it's, you know, the points you give up. It's not necessarily yardage or anything like that, and that's, you know, we stress that to guys. The most important stat on defense is points per game, and, you know, we want to be lower than what we gave up Saturday, but like I said, you got to take that in stride with an offense like St. Ambrose.
I know last week we talked about third down conversions against Marion was high for them, 9 of 15. An improvement on Saturday, 5 of 17 for St. Ambrose.
Yep, much better. We emphasized it all week. You know, we have a session every Wednesday, and each we have inside drill, 7-on-7 and team, and we have anywhere from 6 to 8 plays scripted in there that are third downs. We make it important. We yell it out so kids understand the down and distance and getting off the field. And I think we responded to that pretty well Saturday. You know, and that's, you know, you can't ask for anything more being 70% on third down. Obviously, you'd like to be perfect, but, you know, being 70% defensively is pretty good.
You talk about a team effort defensively. You look at the numbers. There were 11 players who had at least 4 tackles in that game.
I guess I didn't really realize who was, you know, how it was dispersed like that. But, yeah, you know, we talked about, and that was the other thing we discussed last week, was getting guys rallying to the football. And, you know, there were a handful of times guys on the opposite side of the field. I can think of in particular Broderick Patton coming in off the bench. You know, he made some plays for us away from necessarily where he, you know, his responsibility was. He was flying around, and that's what it takes to, you know, to get a lot of guys involved.
I thought the important thing for the defense, though, was they got the initial touchdown, the 2-point conversion, but the defense really, I think, bared down as far as the points goes. It allowed the offense to come back and actually take the lead.
Yeah, you know, we like I said, I think we got better as the game went on, and you know, and that's credit to our guys. They you know, they got stops when we had to, and you know, that was good to see, because we did not get off to a great start, you know, in that first half. But like I said, as the game wore on, our kids got tougher and tougher, and we made all the tough plays at the end of the game.
Waldorf on Saturday. The bottom line is Grandview stands 3-0 in the Midwest Conference, and a chance to take another step in trying to win a championship.
Yeah, no question, and you know, it's not going to come easy, Jeff. You know, Waldorf in the past we've had a lot of success against, but they got a new coaching staff, and I'll say this: they are very, very good offensively. They've got my full attention. You know, so this is definitely a new era of Waldorf football in my eyes. They got skill all over the place, and they're physical up front, which is something I don't know that they've had in the past. But these guys come off the ball and they whack you. We're going to be in for a 4-quarter fight on Saturday. There's no doubt about it.
And they've been scoring a lot of points too.
Yes, they have. You know, and that's, you know, you sit and watch the tape, and you know, and you're looking at it, and you're like, where did all these guys come from? You know, it seems like a whole new team. They got a good quarterback, very athletic. They got, in my opinion, arguably the best wide receiver athlete in our league. You know, he makes all kinds of plays, catching the ball, running the ball, kickoff returns. Very dynamic football player, and we got to locate where he's at, because he's capable of making a big play at any time.
And a chance to get a win heading into the bye week too, which would be nice.
Yeah, that'd be great. You know, we can't look ahead to the bye week, and we got to focus at the task at hand, and that's Waldorf, and you know, we'll get our kids ready to go, and they'll be excited. You know, it's homecoming, and I'm sure there'll be a lot of people at the game, and so they got a lot to go out there and prove, and you know, prove their ranking. You know, these rankings really don't mean anything but at the same time, they've been recognized for some, and they got to back that up.
All right, Joe, good luck.
Thanks, Jeff.
Defensive coordinator Joe Woodley.